Would you like to learn the most important part of setting up QuickBooks Online for attorneys? Well, then you should watch this video, Inputting the List of Products and Services. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. The list we will learn about in this video is a list of services or products that a business would sell to a customer or client. It's something you would list in the body of either a sales receipt or an invoice when the service is rendered. Each item is connected to an income type of account in the chart of accounts. Every time a specific service or product is placed on an invoice, the income account for that item goes up. For example, let's imagine that Ross wants to track the income from notary service separate from all the other income that he earns. In this example, there are only two items Ross would possibly put on an invoice or a receipt. He could put the item called legal services rendered for any normal law service that he does, or he could put the notary service item on the invoice if that's the service that he performed for the client. He wants the income from notary service to be recorded in one particular account in the chart of accounts and all the other income from all the other services can get recorded in the other income account, legal fees earned. So, this is our chart of accounts on the left, and on the right is a general example of an invoice. When you create the invoice in QuickBooks Online, you will list the item that you're charging the customer for and put the money amount on the same line. So if he puts legal services rendered as the name of the item, $500, when he saves the invoice, this account in the chart of accounts will go up because the $500 for legal services on this invoice will be recorded in that account. However, if he also charges the customer for notary services, the money amount on the line for notary services will get recorded into the other account, income from notary services, and that will increase by $1.50 at the moment that he saves the invoice. We go to the top right and click the cog wheel, and we go over to the column that says lists. The second item down is the list of products and services. Double click and the window will open. Now, if this is the first time that you are visiting this window, you could click add a product or service and you would choose, in this case, service. And the name of the service is Legal Services Rendered. And since the price changes all the time, we will not put a sales price. And in your law firm, you could go back and put a description if you want to. However, the most important thing to note when putting the list of services into your QuickBooks Online is which income account will this be attached to. And in this case, legal services income is the account that we wish to increase on our reports at the moment that we place this legal services rendered item onto an invoice or a sales receipt. Now, if we click save and close, we now come back to the list of products and services the way it would normally look. Now, we can make this column maybe a little longer here. so that it's a nice smooth name. Okay, you may notice that QuickBooks Online already comes with two items on the products and services list that you could utilize later, and we will speak about these in a later video. But in the meantime, we have to go ahead and put the other item on the items list because Ross wants to track the income from notary services separately, even if they're listed on the same invoice. So again, we click New and we click Service, and the name is Notary Services. And of course, you could put a SKU or a category or a description. You could make categories of your services. If it helps, a description would also automatically show up on the invoice or sale receipt if you chose to put one in here associated with this item. But the most important thing, even though you could put a price if the price is the same, we don't have to. We can put the price at the moment we record the invoice or sale receipt. Again, the most important thing is the income account that we connect to the item, so that when we put the item on the invoice later, the correct income account will record that transaction and increase accordingly. Click Save and Close, and congratulations. If your list of products and services looks just like this, then you have finished setting up the QuickBooks Online products and service lists for attorneys.